Live from the Dunkin' Latte Lounge.
All right, what up, everyone? It is Garrett from Elvis Duran and the Z100 Morning Show. Welcome to the Dunkin' Lounge. We don't have any graphics. We spent it all on our mug. Hold on. Welcome, Olivia Lunny, to the Dunkin' Lounge. Olivia, how are you?
Hello, I'm great. How are you? Thanks so much for having me.
Oh, no problem. I mean, yeah, I opened up the lounge a little early, you know, swept up a little bit, got myself a latte, and then just waiting around for everyone to show up. You know, that's how it works around here. But
you're ahead of me. I've only had my water. I need to get to my coffee.
Oh, you need your Dunkin' Latte ASAP. And I have a very, very important question towards the end of this interview about lattes and famous people. But I digress. Let's start with your music, because this is all about you. This Dunkin' Latte Lounge is all about Olivia Lunny and learning about you as an artist. And the one thing, reading up on you and listening to your music, I find so interesting. You got started when you were 12 years old, right?
Yeah, I did.
And looking back now, almost what, 10, 11 years later, is it almost looking back at pictures when you're like, when you're listening to music from almost 10 years ago, when like you really just learning about life and versus what you know now?
Oh my gosh, absolutely. And it's so funny, the stuff I used to write about, like relationships when you're 12 year old versus 22, obviously you gain so much life experience within that time period. So, I mean, everyone's got to start somewhere though, right?
Right, of course. So,
but it's fun to take a trip in memory lane sometimes.
Do you remember like that first time you were sitting down to, you know, attempt to write music, what the song was about versus, you know, what it turned out to be? Like, do you have that like memory of like, oh yeah, I was writing about Josh Turner in school? And
yeah, so I actually remember, I think one of the first songs I ever wrote was for my friend who had a bad day, which is so cute.
Daniel Powder.
Yeah, had, oh, true. Maybe I was like subconsciously inspired by that. But yeah, I mean, as you get older, you date people and you go through some stuff. So I definitely draw tons of writing experience from my own kind of personal life.
But then you jumped into the music pool where you're like, you know what, this is my job. This is what I want to do in life. And, you know, you got started when you were about 17 years old, correct? And looking at it then when you first started into the music career versus where you are now, does it feel like a lifetime ago or does it actually feel like literally 5 years ago?
I'd say it goes both ways.
On any given day, right?
Yeah, totally. I think in terms of writing, I do look back and go, wow, I've written so many songs. But when it comes to the industry itself and the people I've met and the things that have happened, I do feel like that has happened all pretty quickly.
have you had that cool moment where you're still a fan of just music in general, but you're also, you know, you're a working artist, producer, songwriter? Like, did you turn into Olivia the fan at any given point when you just started getting into music and you're like, pinch me, I cannot believe this is happening?
Yeah, I think it's a kind of thing that happens almost in a delayed manner.
Right.
So you're writing sessions, you're doing stuff, and then you put out music and then you like get a billboard or something and stuff like that. Those moments, or I got to open for Lionel Richie, was it 2 years ago now, which was incredible.
I love how you just put it off. Like, oh, I got to open for him. No big, like,
I say it's crazy.
Like the closest I've gotten to Lionel Richie is watching him on American Idol. Like, let's be real here.
Yeah, so it's really in moments like that that really, I mean, force you to step back and go, okay, like this, it's happening. The
right
career thing, the music thing, it's happening. And sometimes faster than others, and in terms of like, I guess, competing with myself, right? Some days are busier than other days. Some songs do better than other songs. But at the end of the day, I think it's so important to just sit back and really celebrate the big things and also the little things. Because at the end of the day, if you're just working towards that goal and you miss all the special things that happen, then it's like, what's the point?
I think a lot of people out there in life, you know, have that battle of like fighting within themselves, you know, does it get worse as a musician because you got music, you got to worry about what's posted on social media, what other people think about you? Like, I have a hard time like amongst friends when, you know, I go in the pool and I take my shirt off, you know, it's like, oh, and you look around. But you as an artist, you know, getting judged from any different way, is it harder to compete with yourself than just, you know, not think about what everybody else thinks?
Yeah, that's a loaded question. It's a good question though, but I think in all of this, as I am like trying to grow social media and TikTok and all these other platforms and yeah, music, it doesn't take a side step, but
right.
You really just have to find the happy balance of everything, you know, like Olivia the singer, the songwriter, but also like Olivia the brand or Olivia the social presence. And I'm just really trying right now to find that happy medium. And I think the most important thing is authenticity through it all, or else you find yourself kind of waking up and trying to be that person you aren't. And then that's when you can kind of run into problems with identity. So I'm starting to be myself through it all.
Well, yeah, you're learning, you're learning, like, listen, I can only be me, and that's the best way to do it. So let's talk about music that inspired you. What was that one song that you had that aha moment? You know, like, you know what? I'm hooked. Like, I like this. I like this idea. Like, it could be, you know, it could be the cheesiest of songs. It doesn't matter. No judgment. But what was that song for you?
So I think obviously there's been so many songs throughout my life that are the soundtracks of my life, but I definitely think The Scientist by Coldplay was one song that really stood out to me, and it just made me feel this type of way. And I was
give you the feel, right?
The feeling, right? The feeling.
Yep.
And that just definitely inspired me to want to make music, and Coldplay in general. I've always loved Coldplay. And I remember my dad took me to see them live when I was younger, and seeing them.
I hope you didn't sit anywhere in the upper rafters too, because it for some reason it smells up there in the upper rafters. I don't know why.
No, I was actually lucky. I was very close to the stage.
All right, good. It doesn't smell down there. Up top, I don't know why. They released a skunk or something. I don't know. But yeah, it's very smelly up there. But and the cool thing, like, Coldplay still around, like. How many times has Chris Martin said, you know, and I'm sure you can relate in the sense of how frustrating the music industry could be at times, where he goes, oh, we're done, you know, with Coldplay. And then what's happening, you know, if you check social media as we
record. Coming out, or it came out.
No, it's coming out. It's coming out this, you know, coming out, I believe, this like Friday. But, you know, 5 years later, they're still making music because they got so much to say, too. So I'm sure you could appreciate that as an artist, where you're like, you know what, I got stuff to say, and I want as many people to hear it as possible.
Totally. And I think I really appreciate about them that they're just themselves, right? And they don't necessarily conform to what's hot right now. They kind of do their thing. And that's why people like them so much. And that's why they've had all this longevity through their career, because they've just been themselves, which is so, so great.
Well, I might as well just jump into it now, because I think I already know the answer. If you had the chance to, you know, sip on, you know, a Dunkin' latte with someone and just, you know, shoot the ish and just, you know, pick their brain, who would that be?
Ooh, well, I feel like I have to say Coldplay.
Well, I figured that you could have easily went down that road, but I was like, we're here, we might as well just go for it.
So maybe I would schedule it so I could have three lattes.
Oh, three lattes. Oh, okay. I would be bouncing off a wall, but maybe for you, you'd be chill and relaxed.
Maybe we'll start small. Definitely Coldplay would be incredible. I really dig Harry Styles, and his writing is just so cool and so amazing.
I think
his
style too, like I was watching one, like, I got caught up in like an internet ad where I was, you know, you wait for like the skip button, but it was such a beautiful ad. At first it was James Corden. I'm like, why is James Corden look like he's in a movie? But it was a Gucci. It was a Gucci ad for a handbag that Harry was promoting.
And James Corden is in the commercial. That's wild.
Well, because they're I guess they're best friends. Like, you know, they have that connection. But all right, so we got Chris Martin, we got Harry Styles. Who would that third latte be?
I'd have to say probably Julia Michaels, again, just on the writing side of things. She's dope. She's written so many amazing songs, and she just seems like a really fun gal pal.
I was reading up that Julia Michaels and Sia too, you really resonate with, in the sense. And the interesting thing about them is they kind of have their own mystique to themselves, where they're very quiet, in the sense of like hearing about them or seeing about them, but on the other side, super powerful when it comes to music.
So powerful. Yeah.
Do you feel like that's why you relate to it too? Are you that quiet type of person, but then when pen to pad, microphone, you know, recording, it's like you let it all out?
I think it for sure started like that. As I get older, I am, I think, coming into my own and becoming a more outgoing person. But when I was younger, guitar and songwriting was definitely my way to get out of that shell. And as you said, kind of put it all out there.
Right, exactly. Now it's interesting too, which you know, as artists, sometimes you talk to artists who they're literally, you know, in the middle of their life, and artists like yourself that literally are super young to the industry. When you're with friends, and I get this a lot too, being in the radio, people you meet for the first time, or you from high school or college that you're seeing again, the question of, so what are you doing? Like, do you say, well, I'm a singer-songwriter? Because I do the, I'm in radio, or when I'm just like not in the mood to really describe it, I go, I'm in construction.
I've never done that, but maybe I should just start saying that, because sometimes it is a lot to explain. But I usually say, yeah, I'm a musician, I'm doing music and seeing where it takes me. That's kind of my go-to. Or if family members ask, like, how's the music thing? I'm like, great.
Well, it's funny, like, if, especially for me, it's like my grandmother's like, oh, you still doing that radio thing? I'm like, kind of been for the last almost 50 years, grandma, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, right. I think we are definitely in a space that it's not always common, right? It's a
yeah, there's no checkbox. Like when you go to the doctor's office, they're like, you know, singer songwriter, there's no like checkbox there for you to put or radio. It's always, and then the questions of people that are curious about it, which is awesome. And then you try to describe it and you're like, if I'm describing this to someone that has no idea, I sound so weird. I'm sure.
100%.
All right. So tell us about the songs you're about to jump into in just a second.
Okay, yes. So we have Think of Me, which is a song, how many years ago now? I guess I put my EP out last year. And that song, it's like a post-breakup anthem, and it's off my EP that I put out. And the second song, Sad Too Happy, is actually my brand new single. And I released it, I think, exactly a month ago on Friday. And it's off my debut album that's going to be coming out in July now, I believe, which is super exciting. So I am so excited to share it with the world. And Sad Too Happy, another kind of breakup anthem.
Holding on to new music, is it like almost like a big surprise that you want to tell everybody about, but you can't because of reasons or whatever the case may be? And then once it's out there, it's like such a sigh of relief.
Yeah, it's a strange thing, kind of having this little vault that you
nothing about.
Totally, but it is just so rewarding and amazing when you can finally share that. And I think it just makes it that much better and more sweet when you can finally release it.
All right, Olivia, let's hit up all the hashtags, websites, where we can follow along. So when new music drops and when the world slowly starts to reopen and music gets out there, where can we follow along?
Yeah, so at Olivia Lunny on all platforms. My last name is Lunny. And on Facebook, it's Olivia Lunny Music. But anywhere you stream music, you can find me. So feel free to go check it out.
And hashtag Dunkin' Latte Lounge, DunkinLatteLounge.com to watch this performance over and over and over again. Yes. And any more performances too, please watch that. So Olivia, thank you so much for hanging in the Dunkin' Latte Lounge. There we
go.
It's funny that this is also my cup to drink out of and also my graphics too. So that's how we do it around here.
Perfect. Two in one.
Exactly. Olivia, I'm going to step back, shut off my camera. The stage is yours. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today.
Thank you so much for chatting. It means a lot. Thank you.
We're at the same place at the same time. Do you see me? I hope you do. I want to ask about your new place, but I won't, because I got everything to lose. Every time I close my eyes, a picture runs on a Friday night. I remember all last summer, and now I wonder, do you think of me when you're with somebody else? When you're drinking by yourself, tell me that you do. Do you think of me when you're driving home at night? If something don't feel right, tell me that you do. I hope that I can be dishonest if you tell me you're at ease. I learned to love the seasons. If I don't, then I'll be broke. It's bittersweet. I remember all last summer, and now I wonder, do you think of me when you're with somebody else? When you're drinking by yourself, tell me that you do. Do you think of me when you're driving home at night? summer, we were lovers, made one mistake. Do you think of me when you're with somebody else? When you're drinking by yourself, tell me that you do. Do you think of me, yeah, when you're driving home at night and something don't feel right? Tell me that you do, 'cause I think of you.
Dunkin' Latte Lounge,